What's up, guys? This is Casey Underhill bringing you a Blender tutorial for the week. Today, I'm going to be showing you guys how to make a jack-o'-lantern. It is getting pretty close to Halloween here in the United States, so I thought, why not make something a little Halloween-ish? We're going to do a jack-o'-lantern. So, let's go ahead and get started. Let me turn on my screencast keys for you. Maybe. I updated my version of Blender recently. It might not have screencast keys. Let me double check for you. Screen. There are no screencast keys, unfortunately. So hopefully you guys do not have too many problems following along with me. Okay, so anyways, let's go ahead and delete that cube. And we're going to delete the lamp. And I moved my 3D cursor, so I'll just get that back to where I need it to be here. There we go. And we're just going to add a sphere. UV sphere. I'm going to leave the segments at 32. I think that actually works out pretty nicely. I'm going to scale it up a little bit. I'm just going to rest it right here on the grid floor. Okay. So, now it's all about just making a pumpkin shape. Let's go ahead and make this smooth. And we'll tab back into edit mode. And I'm going to grab that very top vertice. Now I want to turn on proportional editing. And let's go ahead and grab that on the Z axis. And you might have to adjust your circle a little bit using your mouse wheel to make sure that you get enough of it. But I'm basically just going to pull this straight down. Somewhere about there. Okay, and then we're just going to do the same thing for the bottom. And I think this circle needs to be a little bit bigger for the bottom. Something like that. And just pull it up about right there. Okay. That might actually be a little too much. Let's see. Maybe right about here, maybe? Okay, that looks better. So now we need to make our indentations that pumpkins have. So I like to go just about every three or four rows. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, I'll show you. If you hold down the Alt key, it'll let you select one of these lines all the way through, like this. So now I'm going to hold Alt Shift. And I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, and right here, boom. 1, 2, 3, 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 boom. 1, 2, 3. So we are perfectly even. You don't absolutely have to do perfectly even. I'm kind of a stickler for symmetry, so I like to keep mine that way. Anyways, I'm just going to hit S to scale these in. Oops, I've got my proportional editing on. Turn off your proportional editing, and then hit S to scale it in. And we'll scale it in right about there, I think will be good. Now, while I have these selected, I'm going to go ahead and go to Mesh, Edges, and there it is, edge crease. And you'll see when you click on it, nothing happens. But down here in the corner that I can't show you because my mouse won't go down there, you'll see that there's a thing that says crease down here, and it's moving around with my mouse. So I want to move my mouse all the way to the left. Yours might be to the right. Just make sure that it says crease plus one. Once you get it to plus one, just click in, and you'll get these pinkish red lines. Basically, what this does is it's going to stop these indentations from smoothing out, especially when we add a subsurf modifier a little bit later. Okay, so I'm going to tab out of edit mode. And actually, I want to add that subsurf now because I'm going to go into my sculpt mode. There we go. Subsurf. View 2. And I'm going to go into sculpt mode. Now, I usually don't like to use sculpt mode because I feel like you got to be really kind of artistic. And I'm more technical than I am artistic. So I try to keep away from it as much as possible. However, for a pumpkin, you kind of have to. So try and bear with me, guys. Believe me when I say that as long as you get the general shape of a pumpkin, it's hard to really mess it up. But the sculpt mode just kind of allows you to make it a little more random, a little less technical, since pumpkins don't all grow the same. So no matter how good or bad you do, you should be okay. I'm going to go ahead and click on grab, the grab tool. I'm going to hit F, and that's going to change my brush size. I want it something fairly large. And I'm going to hold shift and hit F, and that's going to change the strength of my brush. And I'm down here. I'll do about a 0.5. That might be a little much. Let's see. Okay. So I want to go about front view. Okay, right about here. Just want to start pulling the top out just a little bit, like this. Because pumpkins, they're kind of rounder at the top than they are at the bottom. At least it seems that way. I don't know. I just recently carved a real pumpkin, and it turned out pretty crap, actually. I'm okay with Blender, but as soon as I get actual tools in my hand to like make art, I am terrible. I tried to do a really intricate design. I spent like a couple hours on it. It was bad. I messed up. I ended up like super gluing pieces into it. It was pretty bad. So I came into Blender and said, you know what, I'm just going to make one in Blender because I know I can do that. Okay, so here I'm going to use my smooth tool. Now I actually want to, I'll keep my brush size about the same, but I want to decrease my strength. So I'm going to put it down here about a 0.5 maybe. Okay. And I just want to start smoothing some of this out, especially on the top. Okay, I think I need a smaller brush size and a little bit more strength. There we go. I'm just going to smooth out some of these lines a little bit, some of those ridges. Do the same for these. Just so it doesn't look so... It almost looks like a pepper right now. It's got such deep ridges to it. I'm not trying to make a pepper. I'm trying to make a pumpkin. So we're just going to start smoothing this out a little bit. Getting a little bit closer here. Okay. That. Smooth that out. Okay, now the bottom is definitely, we definitely want to smooth out the bottom a lot. A lot. Just going to grab all these lines that are going into the center. Just smooth them out just a bit. And then down here towards the bottom, we also want to smooth out these ridges that we created. Like this. Aha! And just like that, we're looking much more like a pumpkin now, right? So, I think that's not bad. That's pretty decent. I might smooth out the top just a tad. Just smooth this out. Just a little bit. So those ridges aren't like popping up and over. Okay. So I think we're done with sculpt mode for now. If I get nitpicky, I might come back in here later. But for now, let's just go back to object mode. And now we pretty much just have to make the stem, which is fairly easy. Okay. I want to grab basically these rings right here. I think. Is that going to be too big? That might be too big. Let me see if I can loop cut it. And it's not going to let me loop cut. Well, let's give it a shot. Let's go with it and see what happens. Okay, so I'm just going to hold Alt and right click. That'll give me that whole thing. And then I also want the middle piece. Okay, now I'm just going to hit E to extrude. I'll pull this straight up about here. And then I'll just grab it this way, give it a little rotate, grab it that way. And I'll maybe grab it this way a little bit. We're just trying to make it just a tiny bit more random. Okay. So now that we have that, I'm going to hold my Alt and click these ones. I don't want the middle vertice anymore. I just want the outer edges. And we're going to do Mesh, Edges, and Edge Crease again. Ta-da! Oh, you know what? One more thing. We need to scale this in a little bit. Something maybe here. Actually, you know what? Let's loop cut this about halfway. Yeah. Okay. Now we're looking better. Okay. Grab that one. Just scale that in just a bit. Okay. That is looking pretty good. I'm going to hide the visibility for this real quick, because I think if I edge crease this, it'll end up looking better. Let's see. Do edges. And edge crease. Boop. Oh yeah, that looks better. Okay. So, now what we probably should do is select everything using the A key and subdivide. And let's give it maybe, let's just do two cuts. You might have to mess with this a little bit. This is an important step for when we get to actually carving the jack-o'-lantern. I found if you leave, if you put too many cuts in here, if you put too many vertices, then your pumpkin doesn't feel very round. But if you don't put enough in here when we carve our pumpkin later, it's not going to turn out very well. And you'll see why. It can get a little wonky the way that I do it. See, we got these weird blocky sort of squares. However, we can get rid of those if we just go into sculpt mode again. And let's turn down our strength on that. And we can just smooth it out a little bit. It usually tends to get rid of it. I keep turning the strength way down. Ah, there we go. Just smooth out those squares that we just made with our subdivisions. We don't want to mess with our shape of our pumpkin too much, so you don't want to really smooth the heck out of this thing. You just want to smooth out those weird squares that popped up from our subdivisions. And honestly, I'm not even going to film the back of this thing, so I'm probably not going to spend a whole lot of time messing with the back of it. If you wanted to make a perfect pumpkin and, I don't know, make it for animations or something like that, or make it for 360-degree picture, I don't know. You could mess with it, but for this tutorial, it's going to take too long, so just going to skip the back part. Okay, looks like we're pretty decent on our squares here. It's not great. Could spend more time on it, but it's okay. Like that. Okay, so let's go back into our object mode. And the next thing we want to do is we want to add a displacement modifier. And they've changed up the displacement modifier in 2.72 to where now every time you click new, instead of giving you a default of clouds, it gives you a default of image or movie. And I hate that. I don't know why. I've never used clouds half the time anyways, but I still don't like that it does that. I think I'm going to go with a Voronoi. Yeah. Let me turn this down and see what it looks like. 0.1. Okay. Maybe Alt-A and apply the scale. Freaking motorcycle going by. Jeez. People are up early out here. Okay, let me go back to my Voronoi texture. Maybe turn the intensity down a little bit. There we go. And turn the size of it up. Like this. Another freaking motorcycle going by. Okay, sorry about that, guys. People are being noisy this morning. It is almost the end of October, and it's a sunny day, and it is warm outside, and I live in Ohio. So, unfortunately, people do this. They think they're country people, so they just drive around in motorcycles, loud trucks, all day long. Okay, It's decent, it's not great. We're basically just trying to, we're getting something that is kind of messing it up a little bit. If I turn the intensity up a little bit, maybe. Okay, that's a little bit better. If you really want to make your pumpkin look unique, I would highly suggest spending more time in your sculpt mode. And then use your grab tool and just kind of come around and just start grabbing bits and pieces of it and just pulling it around, because it really kind of adds character to the pumpkin if you have little deformities, misshapen pieces to it. You just kind of pull it around a little bit. Obviously you don't want it to be too much. So if you do mess something up, you can always just smooth it back out. My computer is slow as heck. Okay. Probably gonna undo that last one. There we go. Okay. Anyways, let's go back to object mode. Ba-ba-ba. I think I want to turn this displacement down just a little bit more. 0.07. Okay, that's decent. And then maybe while I'm at it, let me see if I can scale this on the Z. No, I'm gonna keep it the way it is. Okay, so now that we have that, I'm going to... I'm in my modifier tab. Confused myself for a minute. Maybe if I put it before. Okay, that actually looks better. I'm putting my displacement modifier before my subdivision surface modifier. If that makes sense. And I think we're pretty much ready to put the materials on it. So let's go ahead and add a new material. And I'm going to name this pumpkin. If I can spell it properly. Pumpkin. Now before I go in and do anything with the actual nodes, there's something we have to do, which is go into our vertex paint mode. And all we're going to do is paint dirty vertex colors. And you'll pretty much see what it does. That might be just a tad bit too much. Just turn my brush down a little bit. Turn the strength of my brush down a little bit. Ooh, that's a little much. It's not bad. I'm just painting little bits of white on the top because it's gonna add a little bit of a gloss, a little bit of a glare to it. Oh, if this weird jaggy stuff happens, you can either paint over it or you can go down here to paint and smooth vertex colors, and it'll fix it for you. And I'm just kind of painting these gloss lines on the top. It might not end up looking great. If it doesn't, we can fix it. It takes like half a second. But I'm gonna give it a shot. Anyways, once we've done that, go back to our object mode. Going up here and going to compositing nodes. Okay, so let's get started on this. This is actually a fairly easy setup. We're going to go with shader. Make shader. Pow. Shader. Glossy. Pow. And 0.2 for roughness is about right. For our mix, we want a 0.1. Now we need a color mix RGB. We're going to plug that into the diffuse node. And in color 2, we want to pick our nice orange color. Something bright. Ha, there we go. And for color 1, we want something basically the same, but just darker. So I'm going to use this little eyedropper tool and just select that orange color I just had. And I'm just going to darken it up. Something like that. Almost a brown. Now we need to add an input node and attribute. We're going to connect the color into the factor of our mix shader, or our mix shader. And if you click on the vertex tab over here, when we made our vertex colors, you can see that it was saved under vertex colors in our vertex tab. It is named COL by default. If you want to change that name, you can just by double-clicking it. However, I'm going to keep mine the same because the way we use this in our node setup is by typing that name right into our tribute node. COL. And as far as I know, that name has to match exactly with this one. Capital letters and everything, or else it does not work. So once you plug that in, that's basically it, what it does is the darker colors are that we made when we did our dirty vertex colors are going to show up this dark brownish color, and the lighter colors are going to show up orange. And it mixes them together and makes it look really, really neat. So the last thing that we're going to do is make a quick bump mapping here for it. We're just going to plug that into our diffuse, our glossy, add a texture, noise texture. And for the scale, I'm going to set it to 100. Plug that right in here to the height of our bump. And for the strength, 0.1. And that is it for our pumpkin texture. The next part is going to be the stem. So let me add a new one. Actually, I'm going to just copy the pumpkin and then hit 2. Rename it to stem. I'm going to go right in here, compositor, and all I'm going to do is just change these colors. This is going to be a nice green color, something like that. And we'll eyedropper for that one. We'll just darken that right up like that. And we will have our stem. So, Let's go. I'm gonna go ahead and give this a render. Just a real quick one to see how we're looking, see if there's anything to tweak. And if we're good, then we can go ahead and get started on our actual carving of the pumpkin. So I'll meet you guys. Okay, so I see that we forgot to actually assign our stem material to our actual stem. Let's go ahead and hide that render. And for my setup, I pretty much just put a sun lamp here and turned it up to, I think it was 2, and positioned my camera right to the front. If you were wondering how I got lighting and all that kind of stuff. Okay, so I'm just gonna go with face select, I think. Maybe not. Okay, I'm just alt shifting and grabbing these rings. And if you make a little mistake, if it grabs the wrong ring, just hit Control Z. It does that a lot, unfortunately. Okay, for this one, I'm just gonna Z, box select with B, grab that one. And once I have all these selected, I'll just go to my materials, assign the stem. Okay, so that should be pretty good. So let's go ahead and go on to our actual sculpting or our carving of our pumpkin. Since I have my camera right here in front and it's kind of in my way, I can either move the camera to layer 2, and actually I think that's what I'm gonna do. Let me just move that to layer 2. You could also just move your pumpkin to layer 2. If you click on it and hit M, and then on your regular number keys above your keyboard, hit whatever layer number you want to move it to, and that'll move it to a new layer so that you don't have all this junk in your way. So the way we are going to actually carve this is I'm going to use a background image that I selected a little bit earlier. It's going to be something really simple. The more intricate your design is, the harder it is to get it to look right. So this is the one that I have picked. Really simple. I'm just going to come down here underneath my image, and I'm just going to try and scale it and move it around until I get it right about where I want it. So let's see. Nope, not that way. Like this. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Move it up here. Scale it down. Right about here. That'll be about right. And while I'm gonna do this, I guess I'll turn off my subsurf modifier. Go ahead and tab into edit mode. Unselect everything. Okay, so I have my image pretty much right where I want it on my pumpkin. Let me hide my toolbar here. And we're going to be using the knife tool. When you click on it, you'll get this little knife and it'll start making all these little, it'll start snapping the vertices and lines and stuff like that. It looks really weird. If you've never used the knife tool before, it can be a little bit scary because it basically will cut the crap out of your geometry. But I'm here to help you along. So let's click on that knife tool. And I want to hit my Z key, which is going to allow me to cut through the front side and the back side. Technically, we don't want to cut the back side, but I'm going to cut through anyways because our pumpkin has this weird bevel shape to it. And if you don't cut through, a lot of times when you make your shape, it will miss a lot of cuts. It's kind of hard to explain. You can give it a shot if you want to, if you don't hit Z, and it'll just cut the front side, but more than likely, you'll see what I'm talking about where it just misses cuts and you'll have to go back through and try to figure it out. So I just cut through all the way, and if you hold down the shift key, it will stop snapping to all of these lines and vertices and will just allow you to make free cuts. So that's what we're going to do, is just hold that shift key down and then just left click, and we're going to basically just start tracing the shape that we have in the background. And I'm going to do this real quick. I'm not going to do anything super fancy. The more cuts you make, the better your shape looks. So I would suggest if you want to make this look really nice that you take the time to really trace out the details. If you have any experience with like Photoshop or GIMP or anything like that, this is probably pretty familiar to you. Once you get the shape connected, just hit your Enter key and that'll make it cut. And you'll see what it did right here. Basically just made that whole outline. So now while I have this outline selected, I want to go to Mesh, Edges, and we're going to Edge Crease it. Pull our mouse over to 1. And now we need to go to our Face Select mode. And we're just going to select all of the faces inside that we just created. And some of them are going to be really, really small. So make sure you zoom in when you're done and get every teeny tiny little face. Like this one. And this one. And let me make sure that I have all of them. That one. Okay, we have all of them. So now I'm just going to hit X and delete my faces. Ta-da! So if I tab out of edit mode, you can see that we have our shape. Not too shabby. Now we do have a little bit of an issue that happens with this where it just does not like our geometry at all. It doesn't like the knife tool to be used that way. Unfortunately, I haven't really found a fix for it. The only thing you can really do is just kind of move your vertices around a little bit. And sometimes it helps, sometimes it doesn't. You might have to sacrifice a little bit of quality in your cuts just to make it look right. That one does not look like it's going to make it any better. So I'm just going to leave that one for now. And I guess I'll just move on. In the end, it will still look like a carved pumpkin, so don't worry about it too much. There's just a couple of times where it'll have really, really, really weird anomalies that you'll have to try and fix. Anyways, I've clicked on my knife tool again. Click Z and hold down that Shift key. And we're just going to do the same thing for this side. Do, do, do. I am not being precise at all with mine. Obviously, this is a quick tutorial. I don't want to waste everybody's time, you know, being a perfectionist about it. I just want to show you how to do it, give you the tools to do it, so that you can go out and try it on your own. Instead of wasting all of your time watching me do it. Okay, so now let's go Mesh, Edges, Edge Crease, Crease it, and time to grab all the faces. Do, do, whoops. Do, do. Do 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 do. And there. I don't think I had any teeny tiny faces on that one, so delete my faces. Ta-da! You can see we are getting somewhere. Yay! Now on to the nose. We're gonna knife that one. Z. Hold that Shift key. And the nose is super easy. Boop. Hit the Enter key. Oh, it did not select my edge. Ah, hate when it does that. Let's go to Edge Select mode and select all these edges so that we can now edge crease it. Edges. Edge crease. Boom. And delete the faces. Okay. On to the mouth. This one's a little bit more detailed. Z. Hold that Shift. trace along. If you guys want to find a much more detailed pumpkin carving pattern, that is up to you. I will say, if it has a lot of tiny details, the anomalies that I was talking about where it just ends up not looking right, they get worse and worse with small details. And it gets harder and harder to fix, and it starts looking less and less like a carved pumpkin and more like a mess. So try to keep it fairly simple. If you want something incredibly detailed, I'm sure you guys have more knowledge of how to fix those things than I do, but okay. Boop. Ah, it didn't select my edges again. Ugh. Ooh. Oh. Oh, I got lucky. Yay. Okay, so mesh, edges, edge crease, and boom. Go to our face select mode. That's half the reason why we subdivided our pumpkin in the beginning is because of those crazy anomalies that you get. I find that the more you subdivide your pumpkin in the beginning, the less those anomalies seem to really affect the overall look of your picture, of your pumpkin. If you don't subdivide it at all, and you leave it very low poly, which you can do, it makes those anomalies really, really stand out. Even with a subsurf modifier. Actually, even more with a subsurf, because that subsurf seems to make everything just a little bit wonky. And grab these faces here. Sorry guys, this is kind of the boring part of this, is going through and just selecting all this stuff. Wish there was an easier way, but this is how we do it. Okay, delete those faces. So obviously we cut through the backside, and a lot of these got edge creased back here. So, I mean, if you wanted to go back through and select these edges and dissolve them, it would smooth out the back of your pumpkin. But since I'm not going to have anybody seeing the back of my pumpkin, I'm not really going to worry about it. I'm not going to bother with it. So, the next thing that we want to do, I want to select my entire pumpkin and probably deselect my stem. At least most of it. Okay, that should be good. And I'm going to extrude it. Right click so that it just stays right where it's at. And I'm going to scale it down. And what this is going to do is it's going to add... Oops. That's... I don't want to scale it down, I want to scale it up. No? No. Hold on. I did something weird here. Okay. Forget about the stem. Leave the stem in here, select everything, and then we'll extrude it, right click, and then scale it up. There we go. Much better. This is just adding thickness to the pumpkin. Like that. If we tab out, we can pretty much see what it looks like. Add our subsurf back in. Well, all right. Look at that. That actually turned out pretty good. The anomalies are few and far between, which is very, very good. And we have our pumpkin. And the only other thing... I'm not going to do this, but if you wanted to, you could. You could tab back into edit mode, and you can select all of these faces on the inside of your pumpkin only, and on these, you know, these edges that are around your cuts, and you can make a new material and make it sort of a lighter orange, or a less saturated orange, almost a white color, but not quite, because the inside of a pumpkin is obviously a different color than the outside of the pumpkin. It does add a bit of realism to it, which is nice. However, it's a pretty long process, because once you make this pumpkin like this, you pretty much have to select the entire outside of the pumpkin and hide all of those faces so that you can reach the inside faces, and then select those, make a new material, and then unhide everything. It's not a difficult task, but it's a long task. So I'm just not going to include that in here for time's sake of this tutorial. So the last thing that I want to do here is I'm just going to put my 3D cursor inside my pumpkin, and I'm going to add a lamp, and it's going to be a spotlight. Put it somewhere right about in the middle of the pumpkin and rotate it out and go to my lamp settings, and I'm going to set it to about 5,000 strength. Trust me, you need a lot of strength to make that lamp work. Now I'm going to go to my sun lamp. I actually want to turn the strength of my sun lamp down, maybe like a 0.2, because we get a lot of residual light coming from our spotlight, so we don't want to blow out our pumpkin at all. Aside from that, we are done. So let me give this a good final render, and I'll be right. Okay, so one little thing that I forgot. The pumpkin ends up looking fairly plain to me. The part that the light shines on gets a lot of this noise kind of bump texture, but the rest of it just looks really bland. So I have a little trick that I like to do to fix that. So if I select my pumpkin and make sure it's on my pumpkin texture, I like to add a little bit of a displacement. So let me add texture, image texture, and go to my textures. It's under metal. It's going to be called metal painted displacement. And I will show you what that looks like, hopefully. For some reason, opening these crashes my Blender all the time. This is what it looks like. It's just a bunch of black scratches. I made this by taking a picture of metal, desaturating it, messing with the levels, and getting it to this point. It's too long and confusing to explain in a video, so if you want this texture, you can go to my website at www.caseyunderhill.com. That's caseyunderhill.com. It should be the first link that you see will be to this texture. So if you want the texture, you can go pick it up. Anyways, I'm just going to add a converter math, plug this into the bottom value, plug that into my displacement, and then change the math from add to multiply. And then I want this down to like a 0.1 or maybe like a 0.08. 0.08 is probably going to be more accurate. And I believe I need to unwrap this. So I'm going to select all, and I'm just going to project from view. Scale that up maybe a little bit so the scratches are nice and small. Okay. So let me give this another. Okay, so here's our final product. The scratches might be a tad much, or maybe if I place them a little bit more around the edges instead of right directly in the middle of his face. But I think that it adds a little bit of a realism effect to it, in that pumpkins, usually you pick them up at the store, they're super dirty, there's all kinds of nicks and scrapes and bumps and stuff on them that you just don't really see in CG pumpkins. So that's basically why I added the displacement for the scratches, just to give it a bit of a grunge look. Aside from that, everything else is looking pretty darn good. So I think that this wraps up our tutorial for today. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys have any suggestions for videos, go ahead and let me know. If you enjoyed this video, you can go visit my website, www.caseyunderhill.com. There's always more texture files, there's model files, all sorts of things that you can want for Blender. I'm working on improving the site. I'm more of a Blender guy and not a web designer, but We'll see how it goes. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed. Happy Halloween for you in the States. And I'll see you again next week.